All right. Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to the 13th annual tribute to Black music. It's really a treat to be performing for you. We really can't wait to sing this for you. I hope you've been healthy. We have been absolutely ravaged by the flu. So there are some empty places up there that should be filled by people who are kind of sick. And so we're going to do the best we can for you, but that's a little disclaimer, I guess. They'll be fabulous. So we're going to open with what could be called an African, actually Zimbabwean, call to worship. This would be largely African in rhythm and in character, but it's kind of the product of the missionaries that would have been in Zimbabwe bringing some European harmony with them and all, and then the African reaction to European major chords sort of thing, and this would be the result. I published this arrangement a while back, and I had to get permission from the World Council of Churches, and I'd written it in a certain way, and when I sent it for the person to approve, he said, no, this is wrong. It should be written in such and such a way, because he said, in Zimbabwe, the people dance in four while they sing in six. And so that's how this piece is kind of put together. And there's also the wonderful characteristic of call and response, which is so typical of African music. So this is called Uyai Mose. Thank you. we'd like to do a very traditional spiritual. You might call this a concert spiritual because of the way it's set up. This is one of the first spirituals to really make it to, I guess the euphemism would be mainstream ears, non-black ears. This was before emancipation. Deep River Melody became known to people like Stephen Foster and Dan Emmett, who were white guys who wrote minstrel show music. And they tried to sound black and incorporate African-American elements into their music. And pieces like The Old Folks at Home, way down upon the Swanee River, is really based on Deep River, my home is over Jordan. He just riffed off of a spiritual and put that piece together and made a lot of money for E.P. Christie. He never got a cent for it. Poor guy. Poor, lousy business sense, Stephen Foster. Anyway, this is Deep River.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next piece is one we've actually taken to Europe, and a couple other choirs have too, I'm very pleased to say. This is a kind of reworking of the traditional spiritual Ride On King Jesus as a more of a gospel piece. So this is a little bit of jazz influence, but mostly a gospel style rendering of Ride On King Jesus.
Ride on, King Jesus, ride on, no man.
point out that we have several wonderful students here, of course, but we have several distinguished alumni, too. You'll hear Dorian Lake later, but we're pleased to have Connor. Connor Gibbs back with us. Connor just graduated last year, and he's already got music programmed at a couple of music festivals, and his music's been performed and recorded by a wonderful woodwind quintet in the UK, I think. Mm-hmm. And we have Sylvia, Maisonet, and she's on the board. She's back with, looking to go to grad school and actively singing in Voices on the Island and other things. And Nikki Mizrahi, is he here somewhere? There she is. Up there in the back is Seth Price. He, I think that's the old folks. So other than that, it's all homebodies. So thank you so much. We're going to go on now with the vocal group STRETTO. Thank you. Thank you. We had hoped to do take six pieces for you, but owing to a very recent personnel change, we'll only be able to do Come Unto Me from the Take Six catalog. So this is Come Unto Me. The words are actually from the Sermon on the Mount. Jesus Christ, that's an author you don't often get to sing in a jazz group. But this is an arrangement, a wonderful arrangement by one of the members of Take Six, and it's called Come Unto Me.
My burden is light.
going to have another distinguished alumnus join us on bass, Andy Graziano. And Connor is back in his first tenor chair that he occupied in the past couple of years. This is an African-American disaster ballad. This is a type of song that was really popular in the late 19th century, the early 20th century. Songs about the Titanic going down, about the hubris of the people who didn't heed the iceberg and all that, or dire warnings about this, that, and the other thing. This is a real story about one of the many hurricanes that ravaged Galveston, Texas in 1900. And the first composer or author that we can find for this is somebody with the colorful name of Skin Killer Griffiths. He was a preacher, and he did this song in a very different way. This was covered by James Taylor, and we're not doing it really that much like James Taylor, but it kind of pointed the direction for this arrangement. So this features the wonderful Dorian Lake, one of our most distinguished music alumni, and you'll hear the story. Could we turn that buzzing amp off? Okay. So we don't really need the mics that much, it's just the bass, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wasn't that a mighty storm? Wasn't that a mighty storm in the morning now? Wasn't that a mighty storm? Blew all the people all away. Galveston had a sea war, just to keep the water down.
Just to keep the water
down. Tide from the ocean. Blue wall.
This is a piece by Horace Silver. He was an extremely important composer and pianist in a style we call hard bop. And Horace had also a kind of a Latin side. He really liked Latin rhythms. This is dedicated to Nika, who was actually a baroness. She was the last of the Rothschilds. She was in a very unhappy marriage in France. She lived all over Europe. She had five children by some baron somewhere, and she was thoroughly bored. She moved to Greenwich Village and became the patroness of jazz. Charlie Parker died in her apartment. She moved to New Jersey. When Thelonious Monk retired, he went to live in her home. Not a romantic arrangement, just a retirement home for Thelonious Monk. She was the jazz baroness, and so he dedicated this song to her. And it's D.D. Bridgewater, the great vocalist, is still very much with us and on NPR sometimes doing jazz shows. She wrote this lyric. So this is our take on it. It's got a little hip-hop in it now. And this is called Nika's Dream. And Dorian and Shanon have some kind of scat solos in the middle of this, okay? What's that? Thank you, Captain Obvious. Is that what you're saying? Okay. Drums. Thank you. So the African root, of course, doesn't only really sink into the soil in the United States, but also in all of the islands of the Caribbean and in Brazil. And so an Afro-Brazilian genre that came out just as Brazil was really coming into its own in the early 1960s was bossa nova. And this is out of the bossa nova book. It's a real classic. It was a Sergio Mendes recording in 1966, and it's called Mas Que Nada. You're welcome. Our little presentation with a really wonderful little Stevie Wonder tune called I Wish. This is from Songs in the Key of Life, I believe, or maybe it's Fulfilling This First. But anyway, this is a song about looking back on his childhood and what a nasty kid he was and how much fun it was. So here we go.
My toy. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Just as we cleared the stage for Dorian, I wanted to really give a moment to introduce this amazing band. So on piano, Barbara Lee. On bass, Andy Graziano. On drums, Professor David Clive. That's a New Orleans reference, by the way. And on guitar, Mike Hogan. So once again, please welcome Dorian Lake.
Decided to do two originals today. These are pretty brand new. I haven't performed either of these for a crowd actually yet, so just kind of brand new debuts. This first one is just on piano. It's called Lost in the Ballad.
Don't do I got a dog with a Thank you. problem. Tonight, in our concert, our theme, we thought about what would be our unifying factor, and as an educator, I have to be like a researcher and also an educator. And so, for me, what really makes African music, what African music brings to our music, or brings, what brings it alive, it can really be kind of summed up in the in a couple simple words. You have to use two hands, but you say, okay, so it's really that duality between the two and the three that gives the music its lift. And we're exploring that in many different contexts in our piece. The first piece was by Billy Cobham, who also played with John with the Mahavishnu Orchestra, which blended a lot of Indian influences. And that's another tradition in which the duality of meter between a duple and a triple meter is explored a lot. So the next student, we won't talk too much about this, is Jimi Hendrix, from the Skies. Thank you. Okay, well, now you've all practiced, it's time to really crank up that and park the car. Here we go. One, two, three,
Carlos Trump has made numerous numerous brilliant recordings. He is a very, very versatile musician and composer. He has his own voice. He's also a very important teacher. There are all kinds of wonderful guitarists and singers on the island who owe really their formation to Carlos Trapp. And I'm always amazed at the breadth of styles that he covers. Just looking at what's on the program, from When the Saints Go Marching In at Cab Calloway to and Robert Johnson's Crossroads to the other stuff that he's up to. So, you guys about ready? I'll just turn it over to Carlos.
My apologies to Professor Wesby because this one is not on the program. In the water.
No, 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 no. Oh, man, the saints, move my hands. I'm gonna make you mine.